Okay guys, so starting off, I'm going to go in with the Smashbox Primer Water as well as the POREfessional Primer from Benefit. And the POREfessional I'm going to keep in the center of my face, more in that T-zone area because that's where I suffer the most with my pores. And then I'm going in with my Amazing Cosmetics Amazing Concealer to conceal all of those little blemishes and breakouts that I have happening. And then I'm using my It Cosmetics Bye Bye Undereye Concealer to conceal those dark circles as well, because we don't want those popping out at all. And then for my foundation today, I'm actually going to go in with a little bit of this CC Plus Cream. It's from It Cosmetics. I really love it, especially for the summertime, because it is a CC cream, so it's really light on the face. But this one has amazing coverage, and I really like how it wears. And then to highlight my face, I'm going to go in with the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and I absolutely love this stuff, you guys. It blends out so nice. The coverage is absolutely amazing, and it just blends out so beautifully. So I am using this to highlight under my eyes and the center of my face like I normally do, and I'm just taking a damp beauty blender again to blend that all out. Then I'm going to go ahead and set that with my Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder so that it's not going to move or budge or crease or anything throughout the day. And then I'm going to go in with my MAC Studio Fix Powder in the color N5. And I'm just going to use this on the outer parts of my face to set that and just give a little bit of color. Then I'm going to go in and contour with my Hoola Bronzer from Benefit. And I'm just going to use that same little brush that comes with it. And I'm just going to sculpt out my cheekbones a little bit, as well as bronze up my forehead, a little bit on my jawline, and also just a little bit on my nose to define that. And then I'm going to blend it all out with my stippling brush so that it all blends seamlessly and there's no harsh lines. And then I'm going to go in with this blush from Sigma and just apply this to the apples of my cheeks and blend it backwards into that bronzer. And then again, just blending the two together. Then for highlighter, I'm going to go in with my Mineralize Skin Finish in the color Soft and Gentle from MAC. And I'm going to apply this to my cheekbones and kind of make a C around my eye, as well as hit the Cupid's bow and down my nose. Then I'm going to go in with my Mary-loumanizer by the Balm, and I'm just going to tap this on the cheekbones and just put a little bit on my nose too, just to brighten it up a little bit more. And then I'm going to go ahead and start my brows. I do have a video on how I fill in my brows and everything that I will link below, so you guys can check it out if you'd like to see more. I'm not going to make you sit through the whole time that I'm doing my brows. So moving on, I'm going to go in with my Stay Don't Stray from Benefit to prime my eyelids as well as clean up the under edges of my brows. And then I'm just going to blend that out again with that same damp beauty blender. Then after that, I'm just going to go ahead and set my brows with my Anastasia Clear Brow Gel, just so that those brow hairs don't go crazy and they stay in place. And then I'm going to go in with my Jaclyn Hill palette by Morphe. And I'm going to go in first with this color called Silk Cream. And I'm using it on my Sigma E40 blending brush to put through my crease. And I'm just going to diffuse the color up towards my brow bone. I'm going to alternate between windshield wiper motions and circular motions so that there's no harsh lines and it's all blended out really nice. And then I'm switching to my E25 brush, also from Sigma, with the same color. But this is just going to put the color on a little more densely, where you can see it. So I'm focusing it more on the outer corner and then through the crease. And as you can see here, I'm just kind of blending the extra onto the lid. I'm also taking that color down on my lower lash line. And then I'm going to go in with MFEO and focus this color again more on the outer corner and then sweep it through the crease as well. This is honestly like this most simple eye look, but these colors are just so nice to give your eye a little bit of dimension without looking like too much. And then I'm going to go in with this color called In Light and just highlight the brow bones as well as the inner corner of my eyes. And I'm just going to take it a little bit onto the lid to blend it up and really open that inner part. And then I'm going to take this nude eyeliner by MAC and just line my waterline. This again is going to help open up the eye and make them appear larger. Then I'm going to take MFEO on this smudge brush and just line my bottom lash line about halfway in. And then I'm just going to hit the brow bones with a little bit of that highlighter as well to just make the whole look appear glowy. Then I'm just going to curl my lashes and apply some mascara. I'm going to use this Tarte Lights Camera Splashes mascara, which I've been obsessed with recently. I really love how it makes my lashes look, and it's also waterproof, which I love for the summertime. And then for my lips, I'm going to go in and line them with this NYX lip liner as well as fill them in. And then I'm going to go over that with this Glam Glow Plumping Lip Gloss Treatment. And it is just a clear gloss, so it won't add any color, but it has a really nice shine. And then I'm just going to finish everything off with a little bit of MAC Fix Plus to set everything. So that completes this look. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Be sure to give it a thumbs up if you did like it, as well as subscribe to my channel if you aren't already. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. And until next time, I will see you all in my next one. Bye, guys.